Hey guys, welcome to Nashi Blue Tarot. Welcome to this channel. And today I'm back for all of you with another reading. Sorry about the pause for the past 3 days. I was just trying to figure out what to do. As in what reading to do for you guys. So I am back with this question today that what does your person or they want to tell you right now? Okay. So I will be using my channel deck. With that, I'm going to be using a couple of tarot cards. Whatever calls me, I'm going to use that. So let's see what are the messages that want to come through for you. So today the options also you might be seeing are different. I picked up these Buddha statues from Vishakhapatnam, so I thought of using it here. So your first option is this green Buddha statue. I've kept it like this just so that you can see the colors clearly, because the second option is the blue Buddha statue and the third one is the black one. Okay. So these are your options. Look at them carefully. You can go by colors, you can go by whatever. The numbers, I'm not like getting into it. Whichever one you feel called to, whichever one has a message for you, you can go ahead and select that. Okay. So I'll pause for 3 seconds and then we'll begin. 1, 2, and 3. All right, so we'll begin with the green Buddha. So let me just keep it here so that... So let's see what does your person want to tell you right now. I will pick up the channel messages first and then we'll build on it with the tarot cards. Let's see if we get messages from there. All right. Pile number one. What does your person want to tell you right now? What is this? Is this real? Okay. Words cannot express what I feel. Okay, so right off the bat, I think this person is going through a major emotional battle with themselves when it comes to you and the connection. They start feeling very restless. I wouldn't be surprised if you guys are not talking very frequently. I think this person has not felt this way before. Could be a lot of triggers. Maybe you guys are karmic soulmates and you feel a lot of trigger with each other, and so does your person. So he or she starts to get very confused and the battle is just never ending. So maybe this person is trying to withdraw or is not talking that much with you at this stage because they themselves don't know what's going on. So I think they are wanting to keep quiet. They don't want to talk. All right. Let me see tarot card, through the cards, what do we get? What does this person want to say to you right now? Ten of Wands. Yes, they could be feeling very burdened and anxious because of the way they are feeling right now. And I have Knight of Wands and Temperance. So I see a lot of, on and off energy. Maybe this person, at once, they want you. At some point, they don't want you. So maybe they just constantly keep doing this back and forth. And they, at this point, what they want to say to you is that they are trying to balance their mind out as much as possible. And at this stage, there is no balance. Okay, there is no balance. And they feel that whole energy of disbalance, not being able to figure out, trying to figure things out, feeling restless, all of that is going on in their mind right now. Okay, let me see what else do they want to say to you. Okay. This says you're so beautiful. So definitely they're enamored by your beauty. Or if this is a man watching, then yes, your person really likes to look at you, to see you, to feel you, or to just kind of, you know, talk to you, and they appreciate how beautiful or good looking you are. A date. They want to meet you. Okay, I feel. And then I have this one. I can't break this connection. So I feel this person has their own struggles for sure. But at the same time, they can't let go of this connection also, because it is very special. Okay. And the thought of them leaving this connection just scares. It's very scary. Let me clarify with the tarot cards. Okay, I'll use some other tarot deck. Oh, let me use the sexual magic. I think Khadija, somebody from my channel message, they want to see the sexual magic deck. So let me use this deck. What is it? What are they feeling and what do they want to say to you? This person wants you fully, okay? But I feel somewhere they're also jealous. Maybe you are looking at something else, or there are other factors also which play a role here. Okay, so they get scared. Ten of Pentacles. They want you fully is what I'm picking up. They want you completely. They want to take care of you. They want to nurture you. They want to, like, literally give you everything that is possible. But there is some blockage. Maybe the way both of you are thinking is different, and, you know, there are obstacles here. What is it? Two of Swords. So I think you guys are away from each other, or maybe you guys are not fully expressing how you both are feeling or how your person is feeling. One of you is hiding it, and I think this person wants to tell this to you, that they can't break this connection, because even if there are, like, other situations and third parties here, they feel very attracted, and if there is a third party. But I see some external obstacle, because I have 10 of Wands. I see this energy from the sexual magic also. So I feel that they feel a little, maybe you are reserved with them, not fully opening up, or they are not opening up. But they can't break this connection, and that's what they want to tell you. Because it's very special for them. It's very beautiful. It's very serene. It's very comfortable. All right. But again, this person has not felt this way before, so they have their own challenges which they are going through. Okay, so I wouldn't be surprised if they might be, like, a little off. They might be on and off from your life. They might not tell you exactly how they're feeling, all of that. Okay, let me see what else do they want to say to you. I have never got what I wanted. Okay, so now I see this person has some issues of self-worth. This person has some trauma from the past which still haunts them. I need to figure this out. Yes, so definitely with this, what is this? Is this real? And, you know, I need to figure this out. All of these things are showing me that this person is constantly trying to understand what this connection is and how does it work, and, you know, how to reach. I mean, this person is trying to think practically and figure out solutions, but it's difficult. I don't think they will find out practical solutions to this whole thing. I feel this person might just be a little withdrawn at this point, but through this reading, you know that they can't let you go. This person cannot leave you. This person cannot be without you, and it's tough for them. Okay, yeah, King of Pentacles, Four of Wands, the Wheel of Fortune. So look, this person has definitely feels that they keep coming back to you, okay? But could be that this person is married or has some responsibilities which they need to first fulfill before coming to you, all right? So yes, that is one factor that could be a possible problem between the two of you, but there is a lot of burning desire for each other with the Ace of Wands, and this person would really, really go to any length to keep this connection. But again, I don't know what you are going through, because this person has their own challenges. They are enamored by you, this is for sure, but I don't know how long can you pull this through with all the, you know, all of their burden, their on and off and their own confusion. So it's totally up to you. All right. Let me pick up an advice for you, just in case if we pick that up. I'll pick it up from this deck. What should you do? Let's see, what should you do here? Raise your vibrations. Reach for the stars. Okay. So I think you need to kind of understand that anxiety is not going to help you. I can see that, you know, you maybe feel anxious because of their behavior. Now you know the reason why they're behaving this way, because they themselves are not sure. So when you know this, then why are you kind of torturing yourself here? I don't think you should. Okay, I think at this point you should focus from somewhere else. Shine your light. So yes, I think you should put all your energy either in your career or something that you're doing right now, and let this connection go with the flow. See where it is going. You never know what's going to happen here, okay? Because right now, I think for a lot of you, this is a karmic connection which has a lot of lessons. So I can see both of you are anxious. Both of you are feeling anxious. Both of you are feeling this way. So give it that time, all right? Okay, so guys, you can follow me on Instagram. It's Mishi Blue Tarot Official. I do daily 3-card readings over there. Private readings are open, so you can book them if you want, in case if you need guidance. Also, I'll be back with another reading very soon. Please let me know if this resonated, because I do see that this person seems to be very confused right now, trying to figure things out, trying to also not let you go as well in that process. Okay? All right. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye. Okay. So now let's move to the Blue Buddha. Let's see what does your person want to say to you right now? What are their energies? I'll be using my channel deck. Also, guys, you can follow me on Instagram. It's Mishi Blue Tarot Official. I do daily 3-card readings over there, just in case if you're interested. My banner page is linked to the Instagram account, so in case if you want to check that out. Okay, so let me see, what does your person want to tell you right now? We need to talk. One more. Okay, I have a couple of more. So okay, we'll take this. I want to make love to you. I am scared of love. This love is crazy. Would you still love me if you knew this? Okay. So right off the bat, this person is very attracted towards you, and that's what they want to tell you. Okay. I feel that this person is feeling a little all over the place, because maybe this person could have been like in frequent relationships in the past, which were not very deep. This connection seems to be a little deep for this person, so they kind of feel a little lost. So I have seen this for a lot of people, whoever, like, you know, when their heart chakra is blocked, all your energy goes to your base chakra or your sacral, basically, where you just want to sexually explore something. So I feel that this person is not being able to understand this connection, and hence what they think is let me just make love and see what this is. I don't know. I'm picking that vibe up. Okay. But yeah, they do feel that this is a very crazy connection in a good way. Like, maybe their head is going all topsy-turvy. They're not being able to focus, and it's a little all over for them. Okay. So they feel a little scared also sometimes. That's what I'm picking up, and that's what they want to tell you. Also, I think maybe this person's vibe of being with many people or multiple relationships, maybe they feel a little ashamed about it, and maybe they think that if they say this to you, you might not be with them anymore. They want to talk to you. I'm going to pick up tarot cards to see what else, but yeah, they do want to talk to you. They want to express this thing. I'm seeing a lot of communication in this pile. Two of Pentacles, Six of Wands. They want to make a move, but I think they're confused about how to do it. 10 of Wands. They also have some baggage with them. Maybe they are thinking that, okay, there are certain things that he or she might not like about me. And what if they get to know? So will they still, like, will you still be with them? Okay. The Devil. Yes, there is a very strong attraction between the two of you. Very, very strong. And then the Hermit. So this person goes in this whole situation of not being able to figure out, because I have the Empress here. They're extremely attracted towards you, but they know that, you know, they have to give you the best that you deserve. Otherwise, it doesn't make sense at all. Okay? So this person is constantly trying to understand the connection, and it's not like in the process they are giving up on you. They want to still figure out what this is, and they want to talk to you and, you know, then take a decision. So that's a very good thing. Like, I'm not seeing them becoming silent and all. But yeah, sometimes they might, but not very silent. Like, I don't see them expressing their anxieties to you. But yeah, there is a problem. They don't know what kind of a connection is this. And it's very overwhelming for this person, I feel. And that's what they want to tell you. Let's pick up some more messages. What do they want to tell you? Feelings and emotions. Yes, I am a player. See, I told you, although I don't believe in this word, but yeah, I think this person has had really multiple relationships, and because of that, they feel a little scared that, you know, what if you figure this out, and what if you judge them basis that? They're scared about that. But I don't think you should do that, because I think everyone has the freedom to try something and then decide whether, you know, that is good for you or not. Okay, so you never know this person's story. Why did they go this way and all of that? Okay, let's pick up tarot. There are feelings and emotions here. 10 of Wands again. So yes, this person, even if it is very tough, they still want to stick on to this connection. Okay, they feel very romantically for you. But they feel some incompletion here. Like, they just are scared that, you know, they can't have you fully. And they're also scared that you might leave them because you might get something better. And they, of course, we've seen the reason for the insecurity. Okay, so yeah, they feel that energy. Let's see what else. This person wants to hold on to you very tightly. They don't want to let you go, because this person, like, literally, I feel they're insecure. There's insecurity here. This person feels as if, you know, you might leave them because you might find something better. And I don't know why this message is repeated, because I think this person also could be suffering from self-worth issues, and you never know what it is. So this person really wants to hold on to you with every small piece that they have. They don't want to let you go. Okay, let's see what else. Okay, I'm going to take this. This says, I do miss you. I want to travel with you. So yes, this person is hopeful and we've already seen that. This person doesn't want to give up on you. Okay. They might reach out to you sometime soon, but they'll not be very expressive about how exactly are they feeling, because I do see this element of I do miss you, but they won't say it to you actually. They want to travel with you. I think they want to spend time, and that's the theme line we got. We need to talk. This person wants to talk. Okay. Let's see what else. I have the King of Wands, Eight of Swords, and then I have the Queen of Swords. Okay. This person might have like been a little weird with you, or might have just said something which put you off, and you get put off very fast. I see some arguments which puts both of you in a conflicted position, and then you start thinking that, is it even worth it? Like, should I even give it a shot? Does it even make sense? Those are the energies that I'm seeing. So yes, this person wants you with every tiny piece that they have. But I think they have their own battles, and we've seen that. So yeah, they do want to keep this connection. Let's see what you should do. Let's see what is the advice for you. Seek hidden treasure. Okay, that's interesting. Do something different. I love this deck. Grieve your losses. Okay, so this is telling me that maybe there is a past pattern that you keep repeating and that you need to learn and not repeat again. Okay, do something different. Because grieve your losses, seek hidden treasure. So I think this is asking you to deep dive into your whole life experience that you've had till now and figure out that one particular thing or that one lesson that you probably never learned, or maybe there's a mistake that you've always repeated in this process and that's something that you need to change. All right, so that's what I'm picking up for pile number two. Let me know in the comments if this resonated, guys. It was a beautiful reading and I hope that this kind of makes sense. Private readings are open. And you can follow me on Instagram, and I shall bring more readings for all of you very soon, and I'll try to do them more frequently. Take care. Bye. Okay, so now let us move to the Black Buddha. This is pile number three. So we'll see from the channeled messages deck, what does your person want to say to you right now? Let's see. So I have a couple of them. Okay. So how did we get here? All right. I need to figure this out. I'm scared of love. The time with you is magical. This is beautiful and breathtaking. Okay, so right off the bat, I can see that this person is a little worried And I think this person has some really lot of questions in their mind right now. Something happened, okay, and they don't know how did you get here, like how did all of this turn suddenly and what just happened types, okay. So this person maybe needs some time to figure out things. This person is scared of love, but they also know that the time with you, the time that they spend with you is magical, okay, breathtaking, and this whole connection is very beautiful for them. But there is something, how did we get here? So let's clarify this. What is this? Page of Cups. Maybe this person just wants to talk about something that happened. The High Priestess and Six of Wands. Okay. I think the feminine in this connection is kind of walking away. I don't know if this is resonating. If not, then please, it doesn't matter. I'm just picking it up, so I'm telling you. Maybe you're just not ready to listen to something. Okay, and this person is wanting to offer an apology or trying to talk or something like that. Okay, this person doesn't want to let you go, but they are confused. Okay, so if you ask me, commitment vibe, no. Okay, this person is not yet there. What else? Magician. So yes, this person still is very confident. They feel they can fix this situation. Again, Six of Cups. So the number six maybe plays a very important role. I think you guys might land up meeting up, say, on 24th of March or the 6th of April, something like that. Or something might happen on these dates. I am picking up that this person does not care. I mean, in a good way, they don't care if you don't talk because they're very confident that they can fix this situation. I don't know where is this confidence coming from, by the way. Let's see some more cards. This person feels that the kind of emotions that the two of you have, they can make this work out. The Hanged Man. So here, the Hanged Man, I feel that this person might take some time off. Yeah, but after 21st of March, you can expect something from them, a message or something like that. Yeah, because this person doesn't want to let you go. They want you in their life. They see a bright future with you. Okay, that's what I'm picking up. Let's see some more messages that we can get. Let me put this card here. Let's see, what else do they want to say to you? I can't do this right now. This person needs some time off. I need some time. Oh my God, how do these messages link? This is nice. Do I deserve you? Self-worth. I want to know you more. Would you still love me if you knew this? This person definitely has some self-worth issues. And again, they don't know if you would love them, if you knew certain things about them, and if you would actually give them that kind of importance later when you figure something out. I don't know what that something is. We'll check it from the tarot cards. But yes, this person doesn't know if they deserve you or not. But at this point, I think they're taking some time off. They don't know if they can do this right now. Let's see what else. Yeah, it's tough. Nine of Swords. This person thinks a lot about you, but they're unable to do anything. So this is tough. Okay. They are very, very energetically connected, I feel. They dream a lot about you, but I don't think they can do anything about it. And for them, you like the Queen of Cups. They feel very safe with you. Very, very safe. Very comfortable. But yes, again, I have the Hanged Man. So this person just feels that, you know, somewhere, you can do better. Like, why would you be with them? Something like that. Okay. I mean, I don't know what this is, but yeah, they do suffer from this problem, so can't help it, right? I mean, a lot of people have a lot of issues and they suffer from it and you can't do much about it, okay? So yeah, that's what I'm picking up. Let's see some more messages. What else do they want to tell you right now? If there is something else that wants to come through. It still haunts me. God, something happened, is it, between the two of you? Okay. You still appeal to me. I have my own issues. I want us to get back again. Is it only me or do you also feel it? Okay. Lot of thinking and contemplation going on from your person's side, and it's like so much in the head that they are like losing it, basically. Okay, so yes, I think something happened or something that is still playing on their mind, maybe the third party situation from their side, from your side, I don't know. But yes, they can't let you go because I can see that you still appeal to them. They want you back. And if you guys are on a pause, they will be back again. That's a affirmation. The feelings are intense. Okay. The feelings are intense. Let's see what else we get. Six of Wands. Yes, again, we have Six of Wands repeated. So yes, they want this. They will come forward. However, it is, how much ever problems does it lead to in their life, but still they're very determined to have this. Okay, they're very determined, they're very they want it like that way. Okay, because without you, I think they feel sad. And you know, when there is this phase, yeah, I'm seeing a lot of fives here for some reason. So when you're not around, this person has this tendency of overthinking, I feel, and when you're not around, it just becomes even more. Okay, and they keep thinking, but then there are these desires that come up in this person's mind, and at that time, they just want to walk towards you. Yes, they just want to walk towards you, and they get scared because they find you very attractive and they feel very much at home with you, and that's what they want to tell you. Okay, pile number three, you can follow me on Instagram, it's Mishi Blue Tarot Official. Let me pick up a message also for you, I just feel like it. So let's see what is the rise for you. Because this person seems to be lost at this point. Let's see what's the rise for you. Look forward, become a clear channel. So basically, I think, just don't think too much about this. Keep moving on in your life, doing your daily things. Reach for the stars. And one last one, change track. Don't like start obsessing over this thing if you guys are not talking, if there is no communication happening, okay? Just let it be. All right? Okay, so that's what I have for pile number three. Let me know if this resonated, guys. And private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. And you can follow me on Instagram. And I shall be starting soon something with crystals. So I'll be getting back to you guys shortly about that. I know you guys have been very curious. But I'll be back soon. Take care, and I shall see you soon again. Bye.